today, Dean is often considered an icon because of his experimental take on life, which included his ambivalent sexuality. There have been several accounts of Dean's sexual relationships with both men and women. Would you say that James Dean was bisexual?
Did they take...
Look over here.
Wow!
No, we can't print that.
You think you hit the Bobby Sox League? Answer me. You think you hit the Bobby Sox League?
Yeah, all that want to go.
Jimmy?
It's the point of whether I go for the girls, though, you know.
Well, you think the girls go for Jim?
Oh,
look
great.
Size them up.
Kiss me.
Can't hear.
Well, look straight over there at the sun. That's it.
He's a surly bastard.
Exchange places. He's just doing his work. Turn places. You swap places.
Swap.
Turn my back.
Nose to nose. Look right at each other. Profile.
Yeah?
Okay, now ride the camera.
You always have had. Why? Why? It's so easy to be friends with people. Look, man, why don't you just give Dad a chance? Why don't you show him that you love him?
Well, Aaron, I've tried that. How are you gonna do it?
How? It's so easy. Show him. Tell him.
Oh, you show him.
Go up to him and tell him that you love him. Anything. Just show him that you love him.
Well, you just show him. You want yourself.
Me? What do
you mean? I'll show you. Show.
Kate! Who's gonna show him? Who's gonna show him?
Okay, yeah.
When are you gonna tell
him? Oh, tomorrow.
Do something about tomorrow.
Yeah, okay.
Promise?
Yeah.
Swear to God?
Yeah.
Hope to die?
Yeah, well, yeah, hope to die. Get off of me. Big clunker.
Keep quiet. Good night.
Good night.
What?
Schizoid flipped.
Haven't you noticed a personality splitting lately?
Yeah.
Hello. How come you know so much about all this stuff, Plato?
I had to go to a head shrinker. I only went twice, though. My mother said it cost too much. So she went to Hawaii instead.
She going boing boing with a pineapple? Huh? She shaking into Waikiki?
Big black bear, can you snap at her? What time's a pineapple go up? No, seriously, no. No, seriously. Oh, Jesus. Listen, what's your problem?
I don't know. But whatever it is, it's gone now. I mean, I'm happy now. Here with you guys.
Slap happy.
Hey, you know, I came here an awful lot of times before.
Here?
Yeah. You mean when I was here?
Yeah.
When I ran away. Man, I used to run away a lot when I was a kid. They'd always catch me. Mom and Dad.
Mom and Dad.
Man, that was having a battle royal. You know, one night, I was in my crib and I heard them. I don't have any words, just voices.
How can you remember that far back? I can remember yesterday, can you?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, smart asses.
My crib was a sort of cream color. And the paint was chipped where I chewed it off. One night. So what's the difference? Might as well be dead.
Well, it's all right now. You're our baby now. Go to sleep, baby.
But there's a lot of rooms in this place, huh?
But there are.
Want to look?
All right.
Do you? So,
he was fixated on Marlon for a while. I was going to go to a get-together, and Marlon was supposed to be there. And so Jimmy said, do you think I could come? And I said, well, I don't know. He says, I'll tell you what. I'll go downstairs across the street to the drugstore, and I'll call you. And then you kind of see if it's okay for me to come over. So I said, well, all right. So we went to this little get-together, and we played some kind of games. I don't know, you fell on the floor and did dumb things. Anyway, the phone rang, and it was Jimmy on the phone. And the guy whose apartment it was said, no. 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 And he hung up. And so I said, who was that? And he said, oh, it was a kid named Jimmy Dean. And I I said, listen, if he calls again, let me speak to him, you know. So he did. He called again. And he was in a rage. He said, what do you mean I can't come over? What's the matter? I'm sitting here in this goddamn phone booth. And I said, well, I don't know. Evidently, he doesn't think so. He said, all right. He said, I'll meet you back at the hotel, and you tell me why. And he hung up. So when I got back there, he made me imitate everything that went on, what Marlon said, how he walked. What do you mean? Do that again. Do that again. What, just how did he do it? What do you mean? He did, oh, this way, that way. What way? So there I was trying to imitate the way he was talking, the way he was walking. And then he seemed to absorb all this. And then after that, a long pause, he said, I don't know why I wasn't invited.
I remember one story I heard once that he was in the restaurant where either Luella Parsons or Hedda Hopper was. And he was just eating his dinner, but when he saw that this woman was there, he got up and went to the telephone booth and called a friend to find out what Marlon Brando would have done in that case.